Let's get it on film.
Yeah. Well, then you put this and squeeze it?
Yeah.
Gotta break up the spawn.
Wow.
And mimic it in three times. This is the bottom one, so you pop it in. So you want to make sure the hole is filled to the top. There's no air space for contamination, but you don't want to pack it too tight. It might inhibit the mycelium from running. So the mycelium, the white stuff, so you can see this is, that's more of the sawdust, but the white stuff, that's the mushroom mycelium that they grew into it.
Wow.
Before they sold it. So that will keep growing through the sawdust, and then it'll grow into the wood just inside the bark.
Cool.
And then the areas, first it has to hit the right temperature and humidity, which for this one would be, you know, like 40 degrees in the spring. But also as it runs through and it's running out of wood, then the whole idea of the mushroom is they pop up to make spores because they're running out of food and they want the spores to spread elsewhere. So, you know, like almost like bees when they swarm. Yeah, so the final step is to prevent other fungi and bacteria from getting in and keep the moisture in the mycelium. You protect it with food grade cheese wax. And although I'm a beekeeper and it seems like it would be a great idea to use beeswax, you can't do that because when the bears smell beeswax, they think there's a hive and they want to rip it apart to find the larvae, which they like to eat. So some people have had these logs ripped apart by bears. So this is just a food grade wax that has no scent to it, so the bears will leave it alone. And make sure you don't mess with it.
Pretty exciting, right, Dee Dee?
Yeah. Wow.
It's a new kind of farming. They're still weeding.